Today we're going to be comparing five small size daily strollers, meaning for the most part reversible seat models that are built for regular everyday use, but whose key design focus has been on staying compact and light in order to specifically cater to crowded urban environments, use with a car, or any other combination of lifestyle and environmental factors that puts a premium on lightweight and a smaller fold. As a result of this relatively tight focus, you'll notice that the majority of the models in this video tend to share similar characteristics, such as foldable seat frames and a one-piece fold, generally similar wheel size, limiting use to smoother terrain, seats that are less accommodating for children over 3 years old or so, smaller carrying capacity in their shopping baskets, and so on. These similarities can make it hard for people to judge between strollers of this sort, and so today, we've chosen five popular models from the upper end of the market in order to rank them from worst to best in terms of how their engineering, performance, and comfort characteristics match up to the urban and car-focused lifestyles for which I feel models of this sort are primarily built. So, let's get started then, and coming in at number 5 is the Boogaboo B6, which clocks in at 10.5 kilos and folds down to 90 by 47 by 36 centimeters. It can take up to 22.6 kilos in the seat and 4 kilos in the underslung shopping basket. Design-wise, the B is by far the oldest model that we're going to be dealing with today, which speaks positively to its brand recognition and success over time, but which also means that it, unfortunately, maintains some older conceptions in terms of its general structure, which long since ceased to be the simplest and most efficient means of building strollers of this sort. Positively, the B6 has decent terrain capabilities for a small size model, due to an increase in wheel size with the latest iteration, and also because of its well-constructed frontal swivel mountings. And in addition, many of the model's mechanisms, taken on their own, have undergone years of correction and improvement in order to iron out problems. Unfortunately though, as a whole, the model has a number of design flaws, which are the reason that it's placing last today. And most important among these flaws is that the B6 is highly complex and fiddly to use, as over all those years, the design has really just been more added to rather than simplified, meaning that, for example, while it now has memory buttons for a one-handed fold, the number of mechanisms and moving parts required to fold it up and down anyway, in particular when considering the seat frame, creates a wide array of possibilities for loosening and alignment problems. Secondly, the B6 also gets major minus points for being the only model presented here today without an adjustable leg rest, an inclusion which has become something of an industry standard for models of this sort, and which greatly enhances child comfort. Next up and coming in fourth is the doona, which weighs in at a little over 9 kilos and folds down to 32 by 52 by 65 centimeters. It can carry 22 kilos in the seat and 5 kilos in the underslung shopping basket. And to get a little bit of perspective on size and weight here, the Triv is the second to lightest out of these five strollers, though when folded upright is conversely the big bird of the group, tall and lanky and having dimensions that might have nearly fit it in the mid-size category, were the rest of its build not clearly oriented towards the same urban and in particular car-focused conditions as the rest of these models. The chief positive of the Triv, as far as I see it, is the model's folding system, where, in stark contrast to the complicated mess of the B6, it's actually tied with our number one spot for favorite out of all of these models, both for its ease of use as well as for design simplicity, in that the model's locally activated folding mechanism at the center of the chassis allows a Triv to avoid the longer internal components that most of the other models employ in order to get a handle-based fold. As far as the negatives with this model go, however, there are two main issues as far as I see it. The first being the combination of a narrower rear frame in relation to the front frame and very malleable suspension, both of which combine to create a feeling of instability with the model, in particular when carrying an older child. And as an interesting note here, in terms of the rear to front frame proportions, the Triv actually mirrors the B6, but the latter model does not suffer from this feeling of instability due to its stiffer rear frame. The second negative with the Triv that I would like to mention here is the fact that, in the US at least, where the model is most widely sold, the brand has taken a proprietary direction with the availability of car seat adapters in order to push use solely of their own seats. Note that the more common Maxi-Cusi Cybex type adapters are available outside the US, and whether or not they choose to correct this and make them available stateside might well change in the future. Up next and coming in third for this comparison is the Cybex Mios, which clocks in at 8.7 kilos and folds down to 33 by 50 by 75 centimeters. With regards to weight capacity, the Mios can take 17 kilos in its seat and 5 kilos in the underslung shopping basket. The Mios is really the only model from Cybex that I currently feel is worth buying, though it's important to note right from the outset that this stroller requires a bit smoother conditions than the other models in this comparison. Provided then that your needs are more LA, Dubai, or new development American suburbia, as opposed to, for example, cobblestoney European capitals, then this model could be a good fit for you. And despite its slightly lower terrain capability, the Mios gets our number 3 spot today for its incredible design efficiency, both with regards to structural strength and ease of use in comparison to the model size and weight, where everything on the Mios just has a feeling of mathematical correctness to me, from the thickness of the bars and the small scale of the build to the cleverly constructed undercarriage, which functionally contributes both to overall structural stability as well as shock absorption, and even to the mechanics, which often feel too weak on other Cybex models of larger construction, but which feel correctly proportioned here. Thus, despite my frequent criticism of virtually every other model from the brand, this is the one they got right in my opinion. And again, provided that you don't live somewhere too rough and you like the style of the model enough to pay its price, then it's a very fine, almost artisanal stroller to use, which in my opinion would be unfair to place below the B6 or the Triv due to their design defects and inefficiencies. Okay, taking silver for this comparison then is the Jules Hub Plus, which folds down to 31 by 53 by 63 centimeters, weighs 11 kilos, and which can take up to 22 kilos in the seat and 5 kilos in the underslung shopping basket. And the truth is that, as long as you feel that you absolutely need that reversible seat, the Hub Plus is actually my favorite model for this class of stroller, due to having simply a pretty perfect set of characteristics for overperforming in smoother conditions. All lined up, while the Triv may be Big Bird, the Hub is Fat Albert. Chunky, not just in its bars and connection points, but in the size of its rear wheels, and overall, while there's a certain fragility to be felt in all the other models we've discussed so far today, the Hub Plus, for just a few extra pounds, feels a lot more like driving a full-size model's that just been hit with a shrink ray. It's solid, dependable, in a way these other models aren't, has good terrain capability relative to its size, and on top of this, even with its slightly heavier weight and chunkier feel, the Hub Plus both folds quite compactly and has a shoulder strap to allow it to be carried when needed. Maybe not for long distances, but still, easily enough that you feel the luxury of choosing a small-sized as opposed to a full-sized model. In the end then, the Hub Plus is a model that's built simple and sturdy and is meant to last, and above all else, that's the reason that it gets our number 2 spot today. Alright, so finally we get to the number 1 spot. Occupied by a stroller that costs less than all the other models so far, that has the same sort of fold as the Triv, that has an equally sturdy, if not sturdier, construction than the Hub Plus, that has a seat that dwarfs all of these other models size-wise, that is not bound to the same smooth driving conditions that the other models are, but conversely can tackle real off-road terrain better than just about any four-wheeler on the market, and that folds down equally as small and light as all of these other models. And for all this, you only have to give up one thing, the reversible seat. And that model is the Baby Jogger City Mini GT2, which clocks in at right around 10 kilos, folds down to 25 by 79 by 53 centimeters, can take 22 kilos in the seat, and 8 kilos in the underslung shopping basket. As I mentioned in a recent video, most people really have no idea what is given up for that reversible seat, and when we're talking about the more limited use that tends to characterize the lifestyles which harmonize with small-sized models anyway, it seems to me that it's a characteristic worth giving up, especially since you can, of course, use a bassinet or car seat for the first 6 to 8 months. With the removal of that separate seat frame though, what you get is a larger seat, since it can be suspended directly from the handle arms, and a simpler fold. And at the same time, by buying a three-wheeler from a company like Baby Jogger, whose original focus was sporting and off-road strollers, you also get a more robust build, better suspension, and vastly increased terrain capability. There are several smaller size three-wheelers out there, but Baby Jogger has my favorite build at the current moment with the City Mini GT2. In any case, we hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, we ask that you subscribe, as it helps us to continue making videos in the future. If you'd like to know more about any of these models, we have standalone reviews for each of them, and links have been added in the description. In addition, if you are currently shopping for a stroller, we have a buyer's guide on our Patreon page which lists a wide range of models that we recommend, with a lot of technical and lifestyle related information. You can find that by following the link in the description as well. Thank you.